All right, guys. We'll be doing the matchup table for the Azir Irelia. The list will be provided under the in the description. We'll be talking about counter matchups, 50-50 matchups, and we'll not be covering easy matchups because I feel like those just play out itself and there is not much thinking there. But the ones that actually require some game plan, yeah, I'll try to cover them to my best. All right. So first of all, before talking about all the matchups, keep in mind what you're gonna hear. Always take the correction on that you should be playing around spell mana for the spells you're gonna be having in hand. So like it's not always the correct line to take those based on what I'm gonna tell you, based on the pattern, but you should adjust based on what you draw, obviously, right? I'll be talking about what are you trying to accomplish, and you'll have to adjust what you actually draw in those matchups. But those are usual scenarios I go for, and which just brings me good result, yeah. All right. So first matchup, the most common one, Ezreiven, yeah. So in this matchup, you are trying to get Azir and Dias. You keep even if you draw triple Azir, you keep all of them. Like this is because Azir is a removal check. Like they're gonna have they hard mulligan for Cooling Strike in this matchup, and you hard mulligan for Azir. And at this point, the only efficient removal for Azir is Cooling Strike. So if you have two Azirs, it's extremely unlikely they're gonna be able to remove both of them. Especially we are running triple Shaped Stone, so if you play Dias on turn two into Azir and you have a Shaped Stone, and they play Cooling Strike, you basically auto win on turn three, and there is no coming back after that. So in this matchup, you're looking for Dias and Azir. You keep student, but I really like to aggressively mulligan for Azir and Dias, and I usually don't keep student, but I don't know if it's not better to keep it. You have to experiment yourself. I'm going for only Azir and Landmark in this matchup, and if I have Azir and Landmark, I'm keeping Shapestone in my opening hand as well. And attack tokens are extremely important to take into consideration because based on if you are going first or second, you're gonna be mulliganing differently. So let's say against Ezreiven, if you are going on odd attack token, on turn one you want to play either Doomkeeper or Student, turn two Dias, turn three Azir, turn four either you pass. Like this is the turn where they're gonna be trying to remove your stuff. If they pass, that means they'll want you to burn your mana and then play removal. And this is the spot where you just pass back. If they deploy, you can play like stuff like Greenglade Duok and keep your mana for lead and follow, perhaps. Or bluff stuff like Retreat, Recall. Like there are various deck lists. Like people won't know what you are running. So because how like those lists are diverse. So yeah, turn four is usually pass, duo, Dias. Very rarely Irelia, depend on your hand. If you have only units in your hand, you can just puke them out from there. And on even attack token, on turn one you never go to Dunekeeper, you always go either student or droplet, or on turn two you go always duo or Dias, turn three Azir, turn four Irelia duo plus Reborn. Irelia or duo plus Reborn or pass again, depends what they are doing. You can also open attack into pass. Again, it depends what's your opponent board state, and always avoid damaging your Azir in this matchup because they struggle removing Azir and they need to damage it to remove it more efficiently. So you never attack with Azir. Even if opponents has bot with one attack, you don't attack with Azir because you just enable them a flock. Yeah. Yeah, this is usually favorite matchup if you know what you are doing. Like I was believing, like in my previous video, I talked that Ezreiven counters Azir deck. But let's say if a player plays perfectly Ezreiven and players play perfectly Azir Irelia, I think Azir Irelia is ahead. But considering there is not many people knowing what I'm gonna be telling you right now, Ezreiven will still be favorite because people just don't play around Cooling Strike, don't play around removal correctly, and they just drop their Azir when and it dies, literally. Like if you have only one Azir and you have no other threats, try to level up that Azir before you play it and play Azir when opponent taps out, and then you can open with Blade Dance, so he or open with Dunekeeper, so your Azir goes immediately to 4 damage, and he can no longer Quelling Strike it in as a first action to the as the first action. Yeah. All right, let's cover the other match, common matchup, which is Nasus Thresh. Yeah. In this matchup, you are keeping Homecoming in the hand, Azir, Dias, Marshall, Student, Dunekeeper. Student Dunekeeper, Dunekeeper is a keep only if you have already either Marshall, Dias or Azir. Student is always a keep in this one. If you are going on odd, I would argue that Dunekeeper is worth open keeping because they don't have great turn 1, so you can push 4 damage and it's really valuable because it makes their trading later less greedy and they have to trade less aggressively. So, against Susan. You are on turn 1, you are going. You are opening either with Student, Keeper or Droplet. On turn 2, you go Dias or Duo. On turn 3, you open attack. That means if you have like Droplet, Duo, Keeper, you open attack, consider you have one of them on the board as well. Or you are passing if those units are going to be trading unfavorably and opponent has a wide board, or you don't want to, like, if they have, let's say, double Bacchae Reaper on the board and you don't want them to stack them, open pass is a correct play because you don't want to play your Azir into opponent developing Merciless Hunter into it, attacking and Val Feasting your Azir, because then you are just losing the game. On turn 4, you'd usually either, if you pass on turn 3, then you play Azir on turn 4, and if opponent attacks into you, obviously, if he doesn't, if he open pass, you pass back, you have to keep in mind your deck is extremely cheap, and like every time opponent pass, you can your pass is better because you can drop your threats more mana efficiently, and opponent has to pay 3-4 mana per each play in those spots. So like always keep in mind if opponent passes with 4 mana, you can pass with 4 mana and you'll be winning in the by passing in the spots. So turn 4, if you pass, you play Azir afterwards, if not, you play Irelia, Duo or Dias. That means you deploy stuff that don't get affected this turn, and they bring you value by developing alongside them in the next turn. That means on turn 5 you'll be playing, if you have already healthy board like this, you'll be Blade Dancing or just deploying Marshall if you have, let's say, Azir plus Dias, so and or Irelia on board, so you already can take advantage of Marshall buffing up the units, yes? And if you are going even on this in this matchup, then on turn 1 you're looking for only pretty much Droplet. You don't want to play anything else. You can play Student, but it's not the best. If I'm going even, I mulligan one Student because it doesn't do anything in the matchup. I keep Dunekeeper if I have already if I have an Azir, so for the defensive options. Droplet is the only reasonable because it allows you to open attack on turn 2 alongside Dias, Duo, or you can play Conspirator on it to cycle deck a bit. Where you don't want to open attack with Student on turn 2, and then effectively Student gonna attack on turn 4 and he gets chump blocked by something that has 1 HP anyway. So Student doesn't do much in the matchup and doesn't trade with anything. That's why when you are going even, Student is not the best. Student shines when you are going odd against Nasus Thresh. When you on turn 3, when going even, we are if opponent pass into you, that means they have a Merciless Hunter, they just want you to deploy your threat so they can challenge this, so you pass back, as we spoke before. If the opponent deploys, then you deploy Azir. Again, avoid damaging your Azir, so it's not weak to Black Spear, Val Feast, depends, like hand reading comes a lot in this matchup, because if you played the duo previously, opponent didn't Val Feast it, then you can block aggressively with your Azir, or if you have second Azir, or if you have lead and follow. So you can bounce it back in the next turn, and let's say you can replay it, and then play the duet, yeah? Yeah, and the turn 5 is either Homecoming usually or Marshall, depends how the game played out. But at turn 5 and turn 6 we are looking for lethal against Nasus Thresh, even if they deploy Nasus on the board. You can usually, at this point your Irelia is leveled and you can just swap your massive Nasus, even if you didn't damage your opponent too much, but you attacked quite often and your Irelia is leveled, you can swap Azir with 10-12 damage just to connect to the face. You're doing that by the Blade Dancing once and then open attacking, then you have two surges, and it allows you to swap with one unit Irelia, and then usually that's elusive, and then in that spot you swap Azir, which provides basically lethal in this matchup. Counter 6 when they deploy Nasus. Against another matchup that we want to cover is a mirror, which will happen quite often probably. In this matchup, Student is probably one of the most important cards, as well as Azir. So what happens on turn 1, you usually want to play Student or Dunekeeper. Dunekeeper is better, it pushes more damage. Student is better if you want to play on defense Dunekeeper next turn for blocking, but playing on Dunekeeper on defense in this matchup is not really efficient. So yeah, Student is the turn 1 play usually in this matchup. Turn 2, you want to play Dias or Duo to set up the attack on turn 3. On turn 3, obviously, Azir in this matchup, just too good. Turn 4, Irelia, and turn 5, you have Lethal in this matchup. In this matchup, you are dying either, like, if you are... Depends how good opener has. Like, this is purely proactive matchup, and whoever, like, attack going on odd, usually if you mulligan, if you have good mulligan, and if you draw well, player attacking on first should always win in this matchup, no matter how well player plays. If he didn't draw well or he didn't play well, opponent on turn 6 should have always lethal then. Unless he traded his entire board and prevented your lethal and he has nothing on board. But then this is already like considering just a soft lethal because you clear the opponent board and he has nothing to do. And you're just winning on your next attack token. So that's basically lethal as well, right? So play going first, extremely important. And if you're going second, again, you have to hope opponent breaks and you just draw well. So again, you go for turn one student, you keep Dunekeeper for defenses purposes probably. On even, student or droplet, and then turn two you go Dias Duo or Conspirator if you drop the droplet on turn one. On turn three you want to play Azir or Irelia. On turn four, again, Irelia if you played Azir on the turn three. And this is where you have to apply as much pressure as you can, and like your duo, your student duo will be smirking as much. When you are going even, I would say you don't keep Dias in your hand because you need to apply way better pressure. That's where duo shines in, because if opponent didn't get elusive, didn't get droplet, duo actually smirks so much. So I think if you are going second in the mirror matchup, keeping dice is an incorrect line, because it's already, you are in a really bad spot if you are going second. So you should mulligan aggressively for the best possible hand, because it's more like opponent doesn't need that crazy hand. He just needs Azir and student. That's all he needs to win against you. So you should be going towards your own win con on turn 4. Because you can kill your opponent turn 4, or you can clear opponent board on turn 4, and that could lead into you winning. That's why Dias is too slow when going second in this matchup. Yeah, and on turn 5, again, you should be dead. If you are not dead, this is the turn where you play defensively. You can also play Marshall. He can block like a bunch of units. Depends what opponent does. But again, this requires like just reviewing the board state at this point. But this is usually the spot where you have to just hope opponent bricked, basically, because this is just doomed at this point. All right, going for the next matchup. The next matchup will be Dragons, which is probably the worst of the matchups, and it requires a lot of planning, and it's really hard to plan because you have to just ignore that opponent can do like can have sharpsight sometimes, ignore that opponent can have like concerted or single combats later on. You have to just pray. You have to play like this is the matchup where you play the most YOLO, and you just you have to ignore the opponent's hand sometimes. So what things you can keep in mind is not proccing Radiant Guardian too early. That means turn 5, if you have no homecoming or no elusives or no like no Marshall or no level at all Irelia, there is like it requires reviewing your hand. If you basically can, if you have really powerful board like with leveled Irelia, let's say, and Azir, you can actually let opponent pro. If you are pushing a lot of damage that turn, you can let opponent proc Radiant Guardian because you'll be able to push through anyway. Or if you have a homecoming and opponent is tapped out, you can also proc the Radiant Guardian. If you have an OP5 and opponent has 2 mana, so you can back out single combat with an OP5, and you can go for homecoming as well and proc the Radiant Guardian. But basically, the way they win is just Radiant Guardian in this matchup. So, going first. Turn 1, Dunekeeper. You just want to smirk as fast as you can them. Turn 2, Dias Duo. Again, I think Duo is better. On here, when going first, you never drop droplet or student on turn one, because on turn two they're gonna play a challenger and they're just gonna kill it for free usually, and it would force you to play another thing to buff up the unit, and like he's gonna trade anyway, so like there is no point playing that. You can only play Dunekeeper and Smorgh. Turn two is Dias or Duo. You don't mind, like if he kills the elusive, that's fine because like he still removes a body from the board, and later you can play Shapestone into and challenge your Azir. So it's worth to remove that. Like it's worth to sacrifice Duo in this matchup. Turn three, Azir Irelia again. Turn four, Azir Irelia, depending which one you played, or just Blade Dancing, depends how the board state went. Turn five, Marshall or Lethal Setup, because this is the post spot where you usually can kill your opponent. Again, we talked about the Radiant Guardian thing. And turn 6, you should definitely have lethal at this point. If you don't, you're most likely losing. Or turn 6 could be possibly also homecoming. When you are going even, on turn 1, you pass, you don't play anything. You can play droplet if you have a conspirator in hand, because then you just cycle this. Yeah, this is. When going even, the best opener is droplet and conspirator. If you don't have that, on turn 2, you play either Dice or Duo. Turn 3, again, Azir Irelia, pretty simple. Turn 4, the same. Like, the most important thing in those matchups are knowing what do you want to do on turn one and two, because if you misplay on turn one and two, you literally can lose just the game, which could have been easily won. So that's why we are covering those. Turn three, turn four usually are pretty simple. You have to just on turn four could be a bit advanced. Turn three, you have to know when to pass basically. But deploying on turn three is pretty simple. It's just Azir usually. Turn 5, you set up Lethar, play Homecoming or play Marshall. And turn 6, if opponent is not dead, then you're most likely not winning because you're already too behind. And you already vomited your hand and you are empty. Alright guys, I think we covered all the like the bad matchups and even matchups. Again, I'm not talking about other matchups that you'll encounter, like Trundle Lissandra is usually a free win for you. Overwhelm is usually a free win for you. Like, so no point covering those. I think like if you analyze those turns and those matchups, you'll be able to realize what you should do in other matchups based on how those plays out. So I hope this helps you guys, and yeah, have fun. I think like the deck is extremely fun to play, and this should help you. Again, the deck code will be in the description. Cheers, everyone.